I'm sticking at the same level. And sometimes I can speak more or less. About my work, it's harder for me, but I can speak more or less. But sometimes it's very difficult for me to understand when somebody is talking to me. Yesterday, for example, or the day before in New York, I spoke with a New Jersey journalist, and her accent was perfect, very quiet and cold, and I understood each word. And sometimes I did not understand. So I prefer to have Mr. Just in case.
I've been known to talk very fast.
Just in case. And you know, when you have a translator near you, you begin very lazy.
Mm-hmm.
But yes. If we are alone together, right. If I had to, it's very hard for me, but I can try. But I prefer to speak with you with Fred. I'm sorry.
It's okay. So you're still not so anxious to direct a movie here, or?
Non, mais si je devais diriger un film ici, ce serait plus facile parce que le langage du cinéma est universel.
Mm-hmm. If he were to direct a film here, he would actually be able to communicate with the crew because right. The language of cinema is universal.
I worked, for example, for commercials or for short movies in Moscow, in America too, in Beijing recently, with a Chinese team, with a Russian team, and so on. And it's the same words, same. Right. Same behavior. It's easier to work in English than to speak about my work. Yeah.
Well, I actually had the experience. I went to the San Sebastian Film Festival one year, and they subtitle in Spanish if it's English, but I knew the English. But when it's a foreign country, when it's Finland or something, they subtitle in Spanish and not in English. So I speak bad Spanish. Yeah. So I was trying to figure, and the only movie I couldn't figure out was a comedy. Because the verbal usages were throwing me off. It was too complicated verbally, sophisticated. And your work generally is pretty. They're verbally. There's a lot of verbal interplay.
Juste la fin.
Juste la fin. Donc il a pas compris le film comique à Saint-Sébastien parce que c'est compliqué à oui et compliqué à comprendre la comédie. Mais comme tes films à toi où il y a beaucoup inscrit dans le langage.
Mais c'est vrai qu'il y a une tradition assez française qui vient du théâtre peut-être, qui est de faire des films, des comédies essentiellement, qui sont des films sinon bavards, du moins qui parlent beaucoup, où le dialogue a beaucoup d'importance.
Mm-hmm. There is a tradition in France that probably stems from the influence of theater on film, where the comedy derives from a lot of the dialogue.
Et par exemple, quand j'ai fait ce film qui s'appelait Ridicule, qui a été exploité ici, c'est un film qui fonctionne beaucoup sur le verbe, sur le mot, et c'est vrai que c'est très français.
Mm-hmm. Like example is his film Ridicule, that was shown over here. Yeah. That was very much the pleasure of the comedy was in the language. Yeah.
Mais je suis souvent embêté parce que quand je rencontre des journalistes américains ou des spectateurs américains, ils me disent que le cinéma français est vraiment trop bavard.
But he's sort of troubled by the fact that often when he talks to American journalists, he realizes that French cinema is too talkative. Yeah. Or that's the complaint, at least.
Mais moi, je crois que c'est pas embêtant de faire du cinéma un peu bavard si on dit des choses intéressantes.
Mm-hmm. It's okay to have a lot of dialogue as long as you're saying something interesting.
Well, we've lost our tradition here of films of theatrically presented drama. And the comedies have become much broader and more physical, in part because we're trying to appeal to overseas audiences that don't understand us when we tell our jokes. So we've, our comedy business here has failed miserably overseas, including our biggest stars like Adam Sandler have never done business overseas because the verbal, our verbal usages don't make any sense to anybody else.
Oui, c'est ce que je crois.
Ils se sont éloignés du texte ici pour les comédies et ils ont développé plus de comédies un peu grossières
oui,
ou physiques
oui.
et en fait nos comédies ne marchent pas très très bien à l'étranger, comme les films de Adam Sandler qui fonctionnent pas
oui,
bien.
Oui, mais qui est quelqu'un de bien. Mais My Best Friend, c'est un petit peu différent en effet, puisque c'est une comédie qui est très réaliste, naturaliste même. Mais les comédies comiques sont des choses qui ne s'exportent pas, qui restent souvent dans le pays.
My Best Friend is maybe a little bit more of a realistic film, but the you know comedies that function within their own country are often very hard to export.
Juste avant Mon Meilleur Ami, j'ai fait un film qui est une comédie pure, très française, qui a été en France, je dis ça pour... En France, ça a été un succès mais incroyable et qui s'est absolument pas exporté en dehors de la France. Mm-hmm.
The film that he made prior to My Best Friend was, and he want, you know, just to say that to brag a little bit, it was one of France's most successful comedies ever, but it has not exported at all.
Which we don't. It drives me. In America, we've seen about one third of your movies, if that, which drives us crazy because, you know, it's interesting the. There wasn't a time long ago where filmmakers like Howard Hawks and John Ford made a film or two every year, and we saw a lot of movies. We're used to now American filmmakers making one every 3 years, every 4 years. So when we get one of yours every 3 years, we forget that there are other movies in between that we never see. And I know you did, the last one was very commercial, was the third in a series. But we've never seen Brees from Nice here, and we've never seen, though we'll probably remake it, yeah. And we've never seen, I've been trying to get people to buy OSS 117 here, because I love it,
yeah.
And I've seen it at film festivals in America, and the audience loves it, and yet nobody will release it here.
Oui, mais je crois que c'est parce que moi c'est vrai, je fais à peu près un film par an, et que donc il y en a beaucoup qui viennent jamais ici, c'est exact.
Mm-hmm. It's true that he does make a film a year, pretty much, and a lot of them don't make it across.
Mais ce qu'il y a, c'est qu'il n'y a pas non plus énormément de place pour les films français ici sur les écrans américains.
Mm-hmm. And possibly the reason is that there's not a lot of room on American screens for French films.
Dans les festivals, il y a de la place, mais pas sur les écrans commerciaux.
Mm-hmm. There's actually more space actually for the French films in the festival circuit, but not so much in commercial.
Mais personnellement, par rapport à mon travail, j'ai de la chance parce qu'il y a pas mal de mes films qui ont été exploités ici et que les gens ont vu.
Mm-hmm. And as far as for his own work, he's actually one of the lucky directors because a lot of his films have been exported and shown in America.
But you've become a brand name here. Mm-hmm. You know, when people will go to see a Patrice LeConte movie because it's Patrice LeConte. They don't even, you know, people like Daniel Auteuil and everything else, but they're going for you. Mm-hmm. Because we've had such great movies from you in the last, you know, decade.
C'est très flatteur. Je sais pas si vous dites ça pour être poli ou si c'est la vérité, mais si c'est la vérité, je trouve ça très agréable.
He doesn't know if you're saying that to flatter him or if you think it's true. But if you say it truthfully, then he thanks you for that.
No, for me, honestly, and I, you know, it's always good to say on camera, but there are, you know, four or five of your films that for me are amongst the best cinema that we've had in the last 10 years anywhere. So, and it. It's interesting because there's the films that don't get here that are yours seem to be a little bit more kind of the broader comedies, a little more Weber than what we can expect from Patrice LeConte, and yet so those never seem to come over here, and your more serious stuff in the last 10 years seems to come over quite a bit.
Les films comiques un peu plus à la Weber, par exemple, ne viennent pas ici, mais les films un peu plus sérieux que tu as pu faire sont les films qui sont montrés ici en général.
Mais c'est vrai que lorsque un film que je fais, quand j'apprends qu'il est vendu aux États-Unis, généralement je trouve ça toujours assez cohérent que ce film-là soit vendu mais pas celui-là. C'est-à-dire ceux qui sont vendus, je me dis ah oui c'est normal entre guillemets, c'est assez logique que ça puisse intéresser le public américain.
Mm-hmm. When he finds out that one of his films has been bought or to be distributed in the United States, he usually thinks about it and says, oh yeah, that makes sense. That film actually has, you know, a function in the American in the landscape here. And so it's usually kind of an afterthought. He realizes that the ones that are picked for a reason.
Oui. Par exemple, si ici c'était vendu les bronzés 3, je me serais dit, mais ils sont devenus fous.
If you know, a distributor had picked up the bronzés, part 3, he would have said, you know, this distributor is absolutely insane. Why are they doing this? You know?
Well, first we have to pick up Laverne and Save first part one.
Faut aller commencer au début.
Oui, c'est vrai, oui.
So I had this, actually had this conversation just the other day with a new film director, there's a new festival director in Los Angeles, and we were talking about things to do, and one was, let's see the films from Patrice LeConte that we haven't seen, because you can't even get them on DVD here. You can't, they're inaccessible.
Mm-hmm. Un directeur de festival avec qui il parlait. Et il se disait, tiens, si on montrait, on faisait un cycle, Patrice Leconte, qui n'a pas, les films qui n'ont pas été distribués ici.
Ah, alors ça, alors si jamais ça existe, ça a lieu, je vous promets d'apprendre l'anglais pour parler couramment et de venir ici le temps qu'il faudra.
He says if ever that a festival does choose to show the films that had not been exported here, uh-huh. he would promise to learn English and come here and be a host for the.
Wow. Well, I probably can arrange that.
Yes, because for me it's a very good motivation mm-hmm. to learn English, to begin bilingual and so on. If you there are screening about all these movies that you never saw. Yes.
So what are you doing in November?
In November? Okay, I have to learn. Just time for me.
Just a little bit of time left.
Just enough time to learn.
So is there any idea for you of an American legacy? I mean, is America just kind of like a cherry on top of your sundae when it comes to your work? Or, I mean, is it really France, its primary issue, and then everything else is kind of a benefit, extra benefit?
Est-ce que l'Amérique pour toi, c'est la cerise sur le gâteau? Est-ce que tu focalises vraiment sur ton cinéma en France?
Oh non, quand mes films sont exploités, sont connus au Japon, en Allemagne, en Italie ou en Amérique, c'est pour moi une récompense magnifique, parce que ça veut dire que je suis sorti de chez moi.
Mm-hmm. Now, when his film is exported to Asia, Japan, Italy, Germany, all the other countries, he sees that as kind of an enormous reward because it's a way for him to travel through his films.
Mais au départ, ça va vous sembler très 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 bizarre, mais c'est très sincère. C'est que au départ, quand je pense à quand je fais mes films, je les fais pour moi tout seul, pour que ça me plaise à moi. Mm-hmm.
This is strange, but it is sincere. But when he makes a film, it's primarily for himself.
Parce que on peut pas, sincèrement, on peut pas faire les films en pensant au public d'une manière générale. Après, oui, on pense au public pour que ça plaise à un public, mais au départ, il faut vraiment que ça nous plaise à nous, à moi.
He can't conceive making a film thinking about the public. Mm-hmm. I mean, later it needs to find its own public mm-hmm. stuff, but he really, in the filmmaking process, has to please himself first.
Et c'est comme ça d'ailleurs qu'on vit des choses très émouvantes, parce que qu'une histoire qui me touche, une fois qu'elle est réalisée, de penser que ça touche d'autres gens, en France ou en Amérique ou ailleurs, c'est formidable. Quoi. Il y a quelque chose, il y a une communication qui moi me touche et m'émeut beaucoup.
There's something very moving about the fact that if he creates something that moves him, and then it's put out there in the general public or the viewing audience. Also gets touched by that, then it's a way to communicate that is very deeply moving for him.
Have you been surprised in some cases by the degree of response to some of the films that seemed even more personal?
Non, les surprises que je peux avoir quand un film est terminé et qu'il est exploité dans d'autres pays du monde, c'est des surprises qui sont la surprise qui pourrait être la mienne si j'assistais à un miracle. Pour moi, un film qui marche, c'est un miracle. Alors ma surprise est à la hauteur de ce miracle.
For him, a film that works and then works outside of his own country or around the world is the order of a miracle. And so it really, he reacts to it as if he witnessed a miracle.
But are any of the films that you made even surprised you in France, whether they've been well received or as well received as they've been? Something like Girl on the Bridge, which is kind of a mixture of the old and the new, and you know, in some ways it's kind of goes back to the beginning of the new wave, and in some ways it's very modern. So you seem to be working in adjusting the form in that picture as much as anything else, so the drama the surprise or not?
Est-ce qu'il y a eu, est-ce que tu as des surprises en France même, par exemple avec La Fille sur le Pont, où, où tu travailles avec deux styles, un peu un style ancien, peut-être un peu nouvelle vague et aussi un côté moderne. Est-ce que tu as eu des...
Lorsqu'il m'arrive de rencontrer des spectateurs anonymes et qui viennent vers moi en me disant je veux pas vous embêter longtemps mais je voulais juste vous dire La Fille sur le Pont c'est mon film préféré, ça me touche infiniment. J'ai tout fait pour que ça plaise, mais quand ça plaît à ce point-là, c'est une surprise. Oui, j'ai toujours l'impression que mes films ne valent rien.
he's surprised, you know, if somebody just off the street randomly walks up to him and says, The Girl on the Bridge is the most important film that I've ever seen in my life, then he's completely taken by that, because, you know, he never expects that kind of a deep reaction, and ultimately he always thinks that his films don't matter, or, you know, they're not good enough.
Parce que c'est pas du tout la fausse modestie, un peu chochotte comme ça, c'est pas la fausse modestie, mais j'ai pas une très très haute idée de moi-même, en fait, ou du travail que je fais. Je me prends pas pour ce que je ne suis pas.
Without being falsely modest, mm-hmm. He doesn't think of himself as highly, perhaps, as others think of him.
et sur ma tombe, le plus tard possible, je voudrais qu'on mette « Il a fait de son mieux
». And on his tombstone?
Ou « J'ai fait de mon mieux ».
On his tombstone, and I hope that it's not engraved too soon, he hopes that they will inscribe « I did my best ».
C'est déjà pas mal.
That's pretty good already, right?
That is pretty good. So are there filmmakers who you hold in that kind of esteem that... that are working filmmakers now that are incredibly important to you, or you look back at the masters?
Non, j'ai beaucoup d'attachement à un cinéma français d'avant la nouvelle vague, le cinéma très romanesque avec les grands acteurs. Oui, ça oui.
Mm-hmm. He really kind of looks back towards the cinema of before in France, sort of the Romanesque style of film.
Et les films de
Before the New Wave,
de Renoir, de sont des réalisateurs qui... Mais en ce qui concerne le cinéma moderne, j'ai une grande admiration pour les frères Cohen ici.
He has a huge admiration for the Cohen brothers here that are working today.
Et pour beaucoup d'autres, bien sûr, mais eux, ils m'impressionnent beaucoup.
For many other filmmakers, but in particular the Cohen brothers for what they do.
Mais c'est plus facile, ils sont deux. Moi, je suis tout seul.
It's easier for them because there are two of them. He's just one filmmaker.
So do you? So the Coen brothers. So do you? I completely got lost in my train of thought.
Il a perdu son train.
I'm sorry.
Is it brain damage of the train? So what is your? Do you have a favorite film of your own?
Parmi les miens. C'est une question qui m'a déjà été posée et j'ai beaucoup de mal à y répondre.
He's often asked this question and he has a hard time answering it.
Parce que quand je dis ah oui, mon film préféré, c'est ridicule. C'est pas gentil pour La Fille sur le Pont.
Yeah.
Et si je dis c'est La Fille sur le Pont, je dis c'est dommage pour le mari de la coiffeuse, etc., etc. Donc je suis incapable.
So if he says oh my favorite film is ridicule, then it's too bad for The Girl on the Bridge, and then you say, well, okay, well, then it's The Girl on the Bridge, and then that's too bad for
Man on the Train,
or another
train
one.
I prefer, you prefer.
So do you? Okay, so when you are very modest, even and not falsely, but you're very modest about it. But do you see yourself as? And do French filmmakers more than perhaps American filmmakers who have so much frou-frou going on around them? See yourself as a guy who goes to work every day and is just doing your thing year after year, you know, go to the set, direct the actors, make the movie, write the next movie, go on, or...
Oui, enfin, j'espère que c'est un petit peu plus artistique que ça, mais si je travaille autant, c'est pas uniquement parce que je conçois le cinéma comme un travail comme un autre, c'est simplement parce que c'est une affaire de rythme et que je suis très, très gourmand et enthousiaste, voilà, c'est vrai que je travaille beaucoup, mais je n'ai jamais conçu le cinéma comme une espèce de... comme un... C'est dur de faire des films, mais c'est pas un travail au sens traditionnel du bon. Mm-hmm.
He doesn't see it like a grind, like right. He has to go to work, but he does have a certain rhythm that suits him, uh-huh. where he actually works a lot and for artistic reasons. But he doesn't see the work like a worker in a factory or something. It's not a grind. It's something that he does at a certain rhythm.
Do you hang out with the Dardans and have pizza? And I mean, is there that kind of camaraderie amongst the filmmakers in France? It's a much smaller industry than it is here. It's kind of like a monolith here in America. Is there camaraderie and a brotherhood there, or is it kind of like everything else where each person is doing their own thing?
Est-ce qu'il y a une communauté et une camaraderie entre les cinéastes français, et est-ce que tu en fais partie?
Bah, c'est un tout petit milieu, donc tout le monde connaît tout le monde, hein, bien sûr, mais non, j'ai pas l'impression d'appartenir à une famille ou à une bande de copains. J'ai quelques amis cinéastes, mais pas beaucoup en fait.
Mm-hmm. It is a small group of people working in film, and therefore everyone knows everybody, but he doesn't feel like he's part of this kind of fraternity or mm-hmm. or this small. He's actually only friends with just a few filmmakers.
Et en fait, il y a un truc qui est assez, enfin, qui est curieux. Je sais pas si c'est curieux, mais je suis à mon âge juste entre deux générations. Il y a beaucoup de cinéastes français très connus qui sont plus âgés que moi. Il y a beaucoup de cinéastes français connus qui sont plus jeunes que moi. Mais des gens de mon âge, il y en a pas tellement. Dans mm-hmm.
Curiously, and maybe it's not curious, but he is sort of at an age. At an age where there's a lot of filmmakers that are much older, that are older than him, mm-hmm. generationally, and then a lot of directors that are younger than him, and not that many of his age working in the film.
Je sais bien qu'on n'est pas obligé d'avoir le même âge pour être copain, mais je sais pas beaucoup de. Il y a 4 ou 5 réalisateurs français que je vois régulièrement et avec qui je m'entends bien, mais c'est tout. Mm-hmm.
And not that you have to be the same age to be friends, but there's only like maybe 4 filmmakers or so that he sees or frequents as friends.
Well, you're the veterans who have survived.
As opposed. Tu es un vétéran qui a survécu. Oui.
Bientôt, je vais être un vétéran qui aura survécu. Mais je vais m'arrêter bientôt de faire des films. Je vais encore faire 2 ou 3 films puis j'arrête.
He says he's a veteran, but he's thinking of stopping making films in maybe 2 to 3 films now.
Donc ça va être parfait pour faire la grande rétrospective des films qui sont jamais sortis ici.
So it's a perfect time to plan the retrospective for the films that never were shown.
Well, is that because you're exhausted or because you feel like you've told your stories?
Non, je suis pas fatigué du tout, mais je veux m'arrêter bien avant d'être fatigué. Mm-hmm. Et la fatigue, ça peut venir un jour ou l'autre.
Mm-hmm. He's not tired. He's not tired of filmmaking, but he wants to stop before he becomes tired. Hmm.
C'est un petit peu comme si j'étais à table et que je parte avant le dessert. Mais tant pis, je prendrai le dessert un autre jour.
Mm-hmm. It's almost like having a meal and then leaving before the dessert. But that's okay, he'll have dessert another day.
What is making the documentary, for instance? Is that a side distraction that gives you some other energy?
Oui, par exemple, je voudrais travailler de manière plus régulière pour le théâtre. Mettre en scène pour le théâtre, ce que j'ai déjà fait, je trouve que c'est un travail formidable et un peu plus calme que le cinéma. Mm-hmm. Je voudrais tourner des documentaires, je voudrais écrire pour les autres, plein de trucs un peu plus calmes. Mm-hmm.
He'd like to direct more theater, which he has done and which he finds is more calm, also making documentaries and writing scripts for other directors. Mm-hmm. So it's work that's still work, but it's calmer.
Il y a un truc que j'adorerais faire, c'est de tourner un making-of sur le tournage d'un réalisateur que j'estime. J'adorerais faire ça.
He would love to direct a making-of of a film, a behind-the-scenes making-of for a director, on the set of a director that he admires.
Mais peut-être sur le tournage d'un film américain, ou je sais, c'est un rêve impossible, mais ça se fera. Et là, sans doute jamais, mais j'aimerais beaucoup faire ça.
Why not on the set of an American film?
We should probably call the Coen brothers immediately on the next movie.
Si vous les connaissez, vous pouvez leur en parler tout de suite.
If you know them, you can mention it to them right away.
Je suis pas très cher, je suis discret.
Yeah.
Non, c'est bien.
He's not that expensive, and he's kind of quiet on the set.
I'm sure they would love it. So does somebody like you've made this film with my best friend with Daniel? Again, another Daniel movie.
Oui, c'est le troisième film.
So is it, I mean, it seems to, from again, we get a certain, only a certain percentage of the films that are made in France end up here in the United States, but it seems like through each cycle, whether it's Depardieu and then, you know, Binoche and Daniel, that the same actors are working constantly. And that, like every, that they're the, you know, the hardcore crew of France. And they're like in every French movie we see. Is that the perception over there, or is there this much bigger or much wider group of actors over there?
You work with? La France est un petit pays, et les acteurs bankable, comme on dit, sont pas très nombreux en France. Et c'est vrai qu'on voit toujours les mêmes. Mais même en France, on peut vite en avoir assez de voir les mêmes acteurs dans les films, bien sûr.
There are not a lot, it's a small community in the actors community, and there's not a lot of bankable stars, so it's true that you keep seeing the same people in all the movies, and that could be a problem even in France where people burn out on the actors.
Mais c'est la même situation ici. Il y a beaucoup plus d'acteurs bankable parce que le pays est plus grand et qu'il y a plus de films, mais sinon on voit quand même toujours les mêmes un peu.
It's sort of a similar problem here, although the industry is bigger and there are a little bit more actors, but you, in terms of bankable actors, you always see the same people over and over in movies.
It was kind of the fun of seeing François Ozon's movie, Eight Women. It was kind of like, it was like a curtain call for every French actress that we ever see over here.
Les femmes de Ozon. C'était une collection, une brochette de toutes les actrices qu'on connaît ici aux États-Unis.
Oui, c'est vrai que c'était une très bonne collection d'actrices françaises et pas les plus mauvaises en plus. Mm-hmm.
It was a nice, indeed, it was a nice collection and not the worst actresses of France.
Moi, je voulais, c'est des idioties, hein, je suis en train de vous dire, mais je me dis, tiens, puisque je vais plus faire encore beaucoup de films, le dernier que je ferai, je demanderai à tous les acteurs qui ont joué dans mes films de venir faire un petit tour. Un film que j'écrirais pour plein de personnages, mais c'est idiot, je ferais jamais ça, mais ce serait marrant. Mm-hmm.
This is really stupid, but he was thinking that if he only has a few more films to make, he'll write a film with tons of cameos and ask all of the French actors that he, you know, to step in, but he probably won't do it because it's a stupid idea. But
ce serait une espèce de chant du départ, un peu comme la fin du 8,5 de Fellini, où tout le monde vient faire un petit tour de piste.
Yeah.
Et puis on mettrait la musique de Nino Rota.
It'd be sort of like the ending of 8½, when everyone sort of comes and gives it one spin around the turn there, and that he would use the music of Nino Rota.
Et comme ça, on verrait Jean Rochefort, Fanny Ardant, tan 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 tan, et tout le monde passerait comme ça. Ça serait marrant.
Fanny Ardant, Jean Rochefort, they would each come and do a turn with the music and dance.
Daniel Auteuil, Vanessa Paradis, tan 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 tan. Et moi, je serais au milieu avec un chapeau.
He'd have a hat and he'd be standing in the middle waving to everyone.
Oui, je vais faire ça. Alors, je fais d'abord le making of pour les frères Cohen, et après, je fais un film avec.
Okay.
D'accord.
So, two of the 4-3 projects.
Cohen Brothers making of movie, then this scene of in this film.
Ouais. Pas mal.
So, I thought maybe you could do it as a murder mystery and kill them off one at a time. Ooh. As they showed up.
Un mystère de meurtrier où tu tues tous les personnes, les plus grands acteurs français.
Ah oui, c'est bien. Mais pour de vrai.
Snuff movie.
Snuff movie.
Who killed the great? Well, that we'd have to get what's his name, Gaspar Noé, to do it with you.
Okay, I'll come on our way.
You could do it behind the scenes of Gaspar Noé. That'd be something special. Well, it seems to me actually that Ozone, in some ways, has a more. There are so many of these young directors who are coming up with very elaborate ideas of what they're trying to do with cinema there, including the guy who did. Le Vien Rose or Le Moment, who confesses to being ADD and not being able to concentrate for more than 20 minutes at a time, which is how he makes his films, because he can't focus.
Uh-huh. Il dit que il a un problème psychologique qui s'appelle ADD. C'est je connais pas l'équivalent en France, mais c'est quand tu portes pas ton attention plus de quelques secondes sur un sujet en particulier, et en fait ça inspire son style de fabrication de films.
But in terms of flow, it seems to me like Ozone has taken up your sense of the universe and pushes the visual envelope a bit, but also is very much into very personal storytelling at the same time as he's working through his, you know, starting out career.
On dirait que Ozone a pris un peu la place, mais un peu dans la tradition de ce que tu fais, d'explorer à la fois le côté visuel et dans le langage de, mais et avec ces histoires.
Je suis un peu d'accord avec vous parce que je vais beaucoup au cinéma et parfois je suis assis dans la salle de cinéma depuis 20 minutes et les choses, et j'ai envie de dire bon alors ça commence quand votre affaire, parce que les films n'ont toujours pas commencé après 20 minutes et je trouve ça intolérable pour le spectateur.
He kind of agrees with you, and often he does go to see films and 20 minutes into it says okay, when is this movie actually going to start?
Et c'est vrai, j'essaye, je ne dis pas que j'arrive, hein, mais j'essaye quand je pense à un film et que je fais un film, j'essaye de penser aux spectateurs, pas que à moi, mais de penser aux spectateurs qui sont dans la salle s'éteint, le film commence, et comment est-ce que je vais leur attraper la main et que je ne vais plus la lâcher. Mm-hmm. C'est très excitant de penser à ça. Mm-hmm.
Something that excites him a lot is to actually think about how his film starts, how the lights turn down, the screen lights up, mm-hmm. and how he's going to reach out and grab the spectator's hand and pull him into the movie. And that's something that's very exciting for him.
Oui, oui, il y a des gens qui ont le chic pour raconter des histoires de telle manière, dans les romanciers par exemple, vous lisez trois pages et vous ne pouvez pas vous arrêter avant la fin. Mm-hmm. Moi, ce talent-là, j'essaye, mais c'est très très important. C'est une question de politesse vis-à-vis du spectateur.
There's some people that, like novelists for example, that within three pages that you're hooked in and you have to read it to the end, and he strives to have that kind of dynamic, and it's a sort of politeness towards the spectator. It's taking the spectator for somebody, you know, mm-hmm. intelligent that can follow along, grab them, take them along.
So it's interesting because in a lot of, it's kind of become a hook in a lot of American action movies where they have that big moment at the beginning that's supposed to get you, and then they can slow back down and then go back to more action. Whereas you're doing it in a much more kind of naturalistic, dramatic.
Oui, mais quand on fait un film d'action ou un film à suspense, un film policier, etc., c'est relativement facile d'attraper les spectateurs dès le début. Mais quand on fait des films comme ceux que je fais, c'est plus difficile. Oui, c'est plus difficile parce que les histoires sont plus fragiles.
It's true. Actually, in an action film or those types of films, you pack in a punch and then it's easy to grab people from the beginning. But with films that he tries to make that are a little bit more fragile, it's a lot trickier to get that, you know, hook into people.
Well, in your films, you kind of want to know who those people are. You create a very immediate kind of intimacy with that one character or two characters who you want to follow.
Je sais pas par quoi ça passe, mais c'est vrai que les personnages qu'on met en scène, il faut que dès les premières scènes, on se dise tiens, ce type-là a l'air intéressant, j'ai envie de voir ce qui va lui arriver.
Mm-hmm. It's hard to describe how to get there, but within the first few scenes, you know, spectators should be wanting to know more about the characters. What, you know, they should be hooked in and want to know more.
Et à l'étranger, on en parle souvent, on reproche souvent au cinéma français de raconter des histoires très très banales. Des jeunes gens dans un appartement, tiens, il n'y a plus de café, bon, je m'en vais, je te quitte. Bon, ouais, on s'en fout, ça, c'est vrai.
Actually, the criticism from abroad is often that in French movies, nothing happens. Like, you have a couple, they're having a fight in an apartment, he says, okay, I'm going to go, oh, there's no more coffee, I'm going to go out, and by the way, I'm going to leave you. And yeah, that's...
So, Man in the Train, you really did. I mean, by the end, it still wasn't clear to a lot of people what had happened. They knew they had an experience, and a lot of people enjoyed the experience, and still couldn't tell you what they even thought had happened between these two men. Mm-hmm. Is that satisfying in its own way?
Dans l'homme du train, quand on arrive à la fin des films, on n'est pas certain de savoir ce qui s'est vraiment passé. Mm. Est-ce que ça te satisfait encore cette fin, ou est-ce que
Initialement, le scénario de l'homme du train se terminait par la mort des deux à la même seconde, point, et c'était fini. C'était donc vachement triste, mm-hmm. Initialement.
In the first draft of the mm-hmm. film, actually both characters died, and it was very sad.
Et j'ai dit au co-scénariste, je lui ai dit non, c'est trop triste, on ne peut pas terminer d'une manière aussi noire.
So he told his co-writer, It's too dire, we can't finish on that note.
Mm-hmm. Et il m'a dit, mais qu'est-ce que tu veux qu'on fasse? Ils sont morts.
Well, what do you want to do? You know, they're both dead.
et je lui ai juste dit, mais est-ce que ça les empêche de continuer à rêver?
But does death prevent them from continuing to dream?
Et c'est ce qui a permis de faire cette fin un peu entre les deux, mais qui a quelque chose d'un peu positif en tout cas.
Mm-hmm. So it's just, the ending is sort of that in-between part that has an element of positiveness.
Mm-hmm. Je sais que c'est une petite pirouette hein, d'imaginer que les morts rêvent encore, mais sinon la fin était vraiment trop sombre.
It's maybe a little pirouette or a somersault to think that dead people can actually dream, but it was a way to make the ending less dark.
Parce que je veux plus jamais faire de film qui se termine super mal. Je trouve la vie est déjà pas assez rigolote, alors il faut faire des trucs qui vont vers le haut.
He doesn't want to make any more films that have like sad, tragic endings, because life, the world is already tragic enough. He wants to bring people up.
So I sent my friends in a hurry, because I love this movie so much, to see Hairdresser's Husband, and they were angry at me because they fell so in love with them, and then the tragic ending, and it's but to me it was a happy ending. To me it was a beautiful ending because it was, you know, it was in a dark way obviously, but to me it's you know, it's about the power of love as much as dark.
Oui, la fin du mariage de coiffeuse est extrêmement tragique, c'est entendu, mais c'est vrai qu'elle a quelque chose de lumineux et de positif parce que on vient de voir une histoire d'amour exemplaire, quoi. Alors ça sauve la fin tragique, mais sinon c'est pas gay, quoi.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is a tragic ending, but there's something luminous about it as well, because we just witnessed a beautiful love story, and hopefully that carries over. Still, the ending is tragic.
Mais en tout cas, je préfère cette fin là qui est presque romantique plutôt que de les voir vieillir tous les deux jour après jour.
But he still prefers that ending that's perhaps romantically tragic, mm-hmm, rather than seeing them aging slowly, you know, together years and years and years beyond.
Well, that seems to be a theme in the last number of films we got here, and then it's kind of stopped a little bit with Intimate Strangers, but certainly with My Best Friend, where it's, you know, it seemed like you were almost like there was a cycle of aging in the films as we were watching, you know, the discussion of loss and getting older and you know, how to deal with it and what the emotionality of that is. It seems like you're done talking about that for now.
Il y avait peut-être un cycle de films dans lesquels tu traitais ce thème de l'âge, de la vieillesse, des transformations, et que maintenant peut-être que tu es passé à autre chose.
C'est-à-dire que il y a encore quelques années, j'avais peur de vieillir, alors j'en parlais beaucoup, mais maintenant que je suis vieux, ça me fait plus peur, alors j'en parle plus.
So maybe a few years ago he was afraid of getting old, so that was his preoccupation and he discussed that, but now that he is old, he doesn't want to talk about it anymore.
So for a while you saw yourself as Jean Rochefort, and now you see yourself as Daniel?
You are speaking with a grandfather, you know. I'm a grandfather.
You look
sincerely
good.
Yes, I'm a little Lucy, 3 years and a half. So, respect me, please.
Et lui, il a dit avant, tu avais peur de te voir comme Jean Rochefort, et maintenant tu t'identifies avec Danny Boone.
Oh, je m'identifie volontiers à tous les personnages que je mets en scène. Je me mets dans tous. Il y en a pas qui ont ma préférence. Mm-hmm.
He will identify with all his characters, old or young. Or he won't have a preference.
So you identify with the girl on the bridge?
Oui. Je suis à la fois la cible et le lanceur.
He is both the knife thrower and the target.
Well, it's good to be Vanessa. She did well for herself on that. And so when you do theater, you talk about doing theater, you talked about grabbing people at first, is that part of your theatrical directing style as well? Do you look for a piece that you can bring a visual style to, or do you look to have something that's a, you know, full creation of your vision?
Au théâtre?
Oui.
Le théâtre, j'ai pas fait ça souvent, mais j'ai mis en scène 3 fois des pièces de théâtre, et dont une récemment. Et j'aborde ce travail avec infiniment de naïveté et d'insouciance, parce que c'est pas ma formation. C'est comme un autodidacte. Mais c'est agréable d'échapper aux règles.
He approaches theater in a way that's perhaps with a sort of naivete and a sort of do-it-yourself thing, because that is not his training, and he likes that sort of carefree approach to a new medium.
La dernière pièce que j'ai mise en scène, c'est l'adaptation au théâtre de Intimate Strangers, en fait. Et c'est le scénariste qui a écrit la pièce. Et j'ai mis ça en scène, non pas comme un film, mais pas comme une pièce de théâtre, et un peu comme les deux, et ça a eu un succès formidable. Mm-hmm.
So the last theater piece that he directed was a stage adaptation of Intimate Strangers. And he directed it not like a play and not like a film. It was a hybrid, uh-huh. And he had a lot of fun with it, and it was a huge success.
And it converted from the film to the show, to the theater? Not the other way around.
C'était donc le film a précédé la.
Oui, bien sûr.
Yes, the film preceded the
et quand adaptation. Quand j'ai fait le film, j'ai pas du tout pensé que je filmais, que je faisais un film théâtral. Quoi. J'ai pas du tout pensé au théâtre, mais c'est longtemps après que je me suis dit, tiens, au fait, si on faisait ça.
Mm-hmm. He never thought that upon when he was making the film that it had a theatrical aspect to it, but then later he thought, hey, let's do that, and his co-screenwriter adapted it for the stage.
Well, I've been saying for a while now that I think that film has not yet really, and I think it's just maybe beginning to start gain the respect of theater and of novels and of other art forms, and that the kind of fear and anger that is created by remakes and by reimaginations of previous films really should be put aside, because these are art. Each of these pieces of art should be treated like as we treat other art. That there is another life, and there are other interpretations, and they're substantive enough to be worthy of reconsideration.
Okay. Le cinéma peut-être pas sa place à côté des autres arts comme la littérature ou le théâtre, mais on peut peut-être commencer à penser aujourd'hui qu'un film est un objet d'art et qu'il est profond, et s'il y a quelque chose, il peut se transformer dans une autre forme et il peut être adapté comme d'autres formes d'art ont été faites avant.
Oui, peut-être, mais là je vous trouve très très dur en disant que maintenant on peut commencer à imaginer qu'un film est un objet d'art. Ça fait quand même très longtemps que le cinéma nous abreuve d'objets d'art, mm-hmm. et que les grands réalisateurs ont prouvé à quel point le cinéma était un art à part entière.
Mm-hmm. He agrees with you, except for the point that you say only now does film find its place as an art form, or that a film can be a piece of art, mm-hmm. because if in the history of cinema there have been great artists creating beautiful works of art.
But there's been the idea of somebody remaking Jules and Jim the world has come to an end, mm-hmm. when somebody might have something to say about it in recreating it. Mm-hmm. You know, to just remake it to try to make money, mm-hmm. is blasphemous, yes, but that the idea that a filmmaker may have a vision of something else, kind of riffing off of that, seems to me like what we've done with Shakespeare and what we've done with all kinds of other art.
Peut-être la peur de toucher un classique comme Jules et Jim, pourquoi le refermer? Est-ce que c'est un blasphème? Peut-être pas si un artiste qui a une autre vision qui peut apporter quelque chose.
Mais aussi et surtout parce que même si 10 réalisateurs voulaient faire chacun leur remake de Jules et Jim, ça va pas abîmer l'original. Le Jules et Jim de François Truffaut restera intact. Donc pourquoi pas refaire des choses? C'est pas pour les faire mieux. Ça n'abîmera jamais l'original. Mm-hmm. Donc allons-y.
Mm-hmm. Even if 10 filmmakers decided to remake or to readapt Jules and Jim, why not? Because the original is intact. It would not alter that source, and each film would be different in its own way. And
si vous voulez repeindre à votre manière les demoiselles d'Avignon de Picasso, vous pouvez le faire. Vous allez faire une croûte. Ça fait rien parce que les demoiselles d'Avignon vont rester pareilles.
The demoiselles d'Avignon, the epic painting by Picasso. You know, if you want to try to reproduce or recreate or reinterpret it, great. It'll be a piece of shit, but the original won't be marred by that.
Did you see the Five Obstructions? Lars von Trier with a Danish filmmaker,
le film de Lars von Trier.
Non, j'ai pas vu
le titre.
Film, Lars von Trier, when he was a young man, saw a short film called The Perfect Man, made in like 1969. And it's like a 5-minute film, and it's kind of experimental Swedish film. And he found the filmmaker who he admired, and he said, okay, we want to remake the film 5 different ways, but I'm going to give you a list of obstructions to make it more difficult to make the film. Mm-hmm. So one was, for instance, you have to make it animated. Mm-hmm. Or one was, you can't have any shot longer than 12 frames. Mm-hmm. Or you have to shoot it in a poverty-stricken area like Hakata. And the man goes through these experiences, and each of the films he makes ends up being an object of art in and of itself, beautifully done, but completely not what he wanted to do, but he found a way through his art to make it work.
But how many directors did it?
One. This is one director.
Only the last.
Van Trier told him what to do, and he did it.
C'est le cinéaste qui avait fait le film original des années 60, mm-hmm. quelque chose. Il a retrouvé le cinéaste. Il a dit, tu vas refaire ton film, mais avec toutes sortes de
how many different short movies?
He did 5, I think.
5.
Yes, and it was fascinating because it was. So successful, it was really, the movie ended up being about von Trier trying to break him down. He kept on saying, you're failing me because you're succeeding. I want to do it so you can't do it. And I'm going to make it harder for you and harder for you.
Sadistic.
Yes.
It's a funny experiment, you know. I had a dream about that kind of exercise, you know. It's to give the same script. Mm-hmm. At 10 famous director with mm-hmm. High personality and so on, and to see the result. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure with the same script, you have 10 different movies.
Yeah.
If the director have enough personality and style and so right. on, but we can't do it because what's the yeah. point? And who is the audience to see it?
Right.
But
me, you,
yeah. two.
Well, there was also the great last year. Terry Malick did yeah. The New World, and he did a version of it that they showed us in late November, and then he recut it again.
Yes.
And 3 weeks later, showed it to us again as a completely different movie. I mean, it's a lot of the same footage, but one was a movie about nature and. And the other one movie was really about Pocahontas and her story. It was really her point of view, and the other one was not her point of view.
Yes.
And it was remarkable to see in 3 weeks he recut into a whole new vision. And he said he had a third version that New Line, I think, had a heart attack and died before it happened.
you know, this year for the budget of Festival de Cannes, mm-hmm. They proposed to 30, maybe 35 very famous directors to do a very short movie, 3 minutes movie, mm-hmm. about theaters. That's all. You have to do it about theaters. And I saw it in Cannes. It is fantastic to imagine David Lynch, Lars von Trier, Coen Brothers, and so on, Polanski. And the collect was very interesting, yeah. Very sad too, very pessimistic about us, about cinema, theaters. There are a lot of empty theaters with only 2 or 3 people sleeping in front of it's terrible.
Really?
Yes,
we found that on DVD in France, but we haven't gotten it over here yet. I think I ordered it through the Amazon France.
But did you see the collective movie about Paris? Paris,
yes.
I Love You. Did you like it?
I liked a few of them.
Yes.
You know,
how many?
Like
1, 2?
5. Not like 4 or 5 of
yes.
them were interesting enough. I mean, they weren't since...
You're very open.
Well, it wasn't... I mean, well, the thing is, I was interested in the idea that they had the idea more than the execution of the idea, so...
But, you know, when you participate as that kind of collective movie, you have... you have a spirit of competition, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You want to be maybe the best one, maybe not the worst.
Right.
and for my taste, Paris Je T'aime is a very awful experiment.
You made a film?
No.
Well, it seemed like most of the filmmakers
didn't propose me. Yeah. I'm sad, but.
Well, it didn't seem like most of the filmmakers really knew Paris that well.
Sorry?
It seemed like a lot of it was outside perception of Paris as opposed to the kind of intimacy
extérieure
that you might hope on something like that.
Uh-huh. De Paris et pas une vision intime.
Yes, but to do a movie about Paris, it's better, I think, if you don't live in Paris. It's better to have an outside vision about a city, about people, and so on. And recently, I did a short film in Beijing, about Beijing, 1 year before the Olympic Games, right. You know. And they proposed to five director, Wim Wenders, Oliver Stone, Giuseppe Tornatore, fourth, I don't remember his name, and I to direct as they want, right. A short movie about Beijing vision. And it was very exciting for me because it was the first time I went to Beijing for scouting and after for the shooting. And I thought, if Olympic Games was in Paris, mm-hmm. and if the layer of Paris proposed to me to do the same kind of movie about right. Paris, I think I said, no thanks, I can't. Because I know so well the city, right. I can't have a new vision about. And but for Beijing it was perfect because I never went before. So. It's a very particular movie. It's my eye, but I think it. I'm not saying it's a very famous right. movie masterpiece and so on. No, not at all. But very interesting to have a nouveau regard.
So why do you think Paris Attempt didn't work?
Sorry.
Why do you think Paris Attempt didn't work?
Pourquoi est-ce que ça n'a pas marché ce projet Paris Attempt?
I think the reason is very simple. If you turn off the camera, I can say it. No, because the movie are very bad. Bad movies, bad stories, bad film.
See, I think I think there's a pressure when you're asked to do that to yeah. kind of create something, and then Paris is the background or Paris is.
Yes. But no, for me, it's a very good idea
yeah.
and a very bad result.
Well, unfortunately, we had the same with the New York stories.
Yes.
With Scorsese and Coppola and Allen, all very good filmmakers, but the two out of three kind of sucked, sadly.
Only three.
Yeah, and of course, we haven't seen much from Coppola since then, but fortunately, he's back to work also.
Yeah.
Like you, he's a grandfather and happy to go back to work, finally.
I'm a grandfather, but don't repeat it.
Well, you look very good, and thank you so much for coming. And
thank you very much. So sorry about English, and but
no,
next time for myself festival.
The Confest, we're gonna call it. No, I think it's a great idea, and we just have to figure out the third movie you're gonna make before you quit. Now. Because you got the Coen brothers behind the screen. We got two of the three movies for you now before you
have to go. No, it's
a side project.
Out of the series. No, it's three more movies, but I have to do a kind of new Monsieur here. You see Monsieur here? Do you know Monsieur here? And Paul Auster, a famous novelist in.
Great novelist.
Yes, wrote a new adaptation. Very, very interesting about this book, and cross your fingers as me. I think I'll reshoot it in New York next spring, next spring in 1 year. But each year, the producer said, no, not this year, but maybe the next year. And I think it's it will release for the shooting next spring, but who knows. When I will said action and cut, I will be sure to direct this movie. For the moment,
it's all cut. Thank you very much.
Thank you to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, Fred.
Hey.
My pleasure.
We're out.
Oh, you might like that.
Yeah, I'm sure.